Well, hello and welcome back to Christchurch. Today we're taking a look at the Solar Alpha Rotary Joint and of the International Space Station. It's called the SARJ. We'll be using this small ball bearing, approximately, well actually exactly 30 mil outside, 17 inside, 7 mils deep. So it matches the size of the SARJ very closely. Turns beautifully smoothly, and of course is many, many hundreds of times stronger than it needs to be, which is just the way I like it. And the way it works is this. On one side, on P3, you can see here I've turned up a small wooden plug which is glued right in the middle there, outside stabilizer ring, which is just to hide the solar joint. And on P4, here you can see I've simply glued the outer casing of the bearing directly to the backing plate for P4, so the inside of the bearing still rotates. And it's a pretty simple matter of putting it together. We simply take both parts, give it a good, give it a really good squash, and then it's stuck fast, and the whole contraption moves absolutely beautifully. You'll notice that I can put a lot of sideways pressure. You can see how hard I'm pushing down there, which means that the joint is going to be able to support the outboard solar arrays with no problem, and I'll be able to pull the arrays directly off the main truss for storage, transportation, or repairs. So that's how I've chosen to make the SARJ. You can probably also see in here that I've also actually used wooden dowels as opposed to cardboard tubes to connect the SARJ directly to P4. And I wanted to do that because it's much, much stronger than paper. And it was also much, much easier as well, trimming down small dowels is a lot easier than trimming down paper tubes. So this whole part of the station is remarkably robust, and of course it needs to be because I want my solar panels to be completely self-supporting in a gravity environment. So look, that's P4 and P3. And if you'd like to see how I connected P4 onto the solar joint, then you could take a look at the thread that's in the description, and it shows you how I did that. It's really pretty simple. Thanks for dropping by.